Hi everyone, Leanne here from Jaded Blossom, and it is day two of our Jaded Blossom June release. Hey, so I'm using Jaded Blossom's Girl Gnome Dies, their Gnome Dies Baking Add Ons, their Gnome Dies Thanksgiving Add Ons, the Build-A-Booth Die, the Fired Up Stamp Set, along with the Barbecue 6-inch pad from Doodlebug, P13 Stamping Pad Skin Tones, American Crafts Silver Foil Cardstock. I'm also using the brand new stamp set Lemonade for Sale from Jaded Blossom. So first of all, I made an A2 sized vertical white card out of paper tray ink white cardstock, 4.25 by 11, scored at 5.5 inches with my Martha Stewart scoreboard and my Teflon bone folder. Then I cut this paper from that barbecue pad, 1/8 of an inch smaller than that A2 size card front. And I'm going to put that on my card base with some ATG tape, working on a Stampin' Up pad. All my die cutting today was done with my Gemini machine. Now I did put together this booth off screen and I used paper tray ink craft cardstock. You'll see that I colored with Copic marker behind the little nail heads to make it look like they're black. And then I'm sticking it down with art glitter glue and ATG tape. So I'm just going to stick that down onto my background. So there it is in place. And I went ahead and I stamped that I Love Barbecue from the Lemonade for Sale stamp set with Versafine Claire Nocturne ink onto Nina Solar White 80 pound cardstock. And I'm using the little Build-A-Booth sign to cut it out. I'll just tape that down. I'll run it through my Gemini. There we go. And now I cut this little heart from the Gnome Dies Baking Add-Ons. They're the little cookie icing images. And one fits perfectly. Look at that. So I'm going to pop up that sign with 3M foam tape. There we go. On an angle. And then I'm going to pop up that little heart, pure poppy cardstock from Paper Tray Ink. And I'll pop that up with using my reverse tweezers and a Stampin' Up! Dimensional. There we go. Fits perfect. Okay, so now I'm going to add a 1-inch strip of paper from this pad, from that barbecue pad, and then a 1 1/4 inch strip of this one that's also from that Doodlebug barbecue pad. And I'm just going to add those to the inside to decorate the inside of the card. And I'll stick that down with some art glitter glue. Or no, with some ATG tape. Sorry, guys. I'm in my own little world here. Okay, I'm going to trim off the overhang with a pair of scissors. There we go. And then I'll add this little piece. I'm adding this piece with some art glitter glue. There you go. It's got little, I don't know if they're turkey legs or chicken legs, but so cute. So I'm gonna add those down. So fun little barbecue. Okay, now I'm putting together this little girl gnome. Cut the dress out of that barbecue pad from Doodlebug. The back layer was cut out of American Crafts black cardstock. This was cut out of Paper Tray Ink white cardstock. So you want to line that up on the bottom. You always start with the dress, with the girl. And then we will stick down the little face cut from P13 Stamping Pad Skin Tones. You want to line that up with the apron. There we go. It fits perfectly. There you have it. Now next, I'm going to put together the chef hat. So the main hat was cut out of that same paper from the barbecue pad. And then I cut the top out of white paper tray ink cardstock. I'm going to trim off that hat so this one fits on well. And then I'll just stick that down with some art glitter glue. There we go. So I got a cute little barbecue girl going. And then I do take the Stampin' Up! Dimensionals to pop up the little nose. Then I realize I've got to put the hair on first. So I'm going to glue the hair down. That is cut out of American Crafts yellow cardstock. And you want to line that up with the bottom of the hat. The hair always lines up with the bottom of the hat. And then I'll pop up the little nose. And isn't that cute? Okay, so next I'm going to pop the feet on with some Stampin' Up! Dimensionals. There we go. Perfect. Okay. And now I'm going to put together the little turkey leg. That was cut from the Gnome Dies Thanksgiving add-ons. So it's a little turkey leg, rust cardstock from American Crafts and Paper Tray Ink craft cardstock for the spoon and for the little bone. And then I'm going to pop these up. And then I'm just going to stick the little hands down flat on top of the little spoon and on the top of the little turkey leg. I thought these were perfect little accompaniments to have a little barbecuing girl in front of her barbecue booth, right? So there we go. And I'll get her all stuck down. And I just, you know, I trim these up. I trim the edges of the Stampin' Up! Dimensionals up. You might as well. Got to use up all the little pieces. And I like everything levelly lifted up so it doesn't dent in the mail, you know. There we go. And I will pop up her little hand with some Stampin' Up! Dimensionals, obviously cut from that same P13 stamping pad skin tones. And there you have it. Oh, isn't she cute? Okay, so now I have this little whisk. I'm going to cut off the little hand. I'm going to add the little handle that's cut out of pure poppy cardstock. The silver whisk was cut from American Crafts Christmas foil, the same as the bowl. And then I'm going to add the little barbecue sauce in that bowl, cut out of that rust cardstock again from American Crafts. So stuck down with some art glitter glue. And then I will be popping that up with some dimensionals so it can sit right on top of that booth, which is kind of fun. So just popping up dimensionals. There we go. And then figuring out where my little barbecue girl's going. And then I'm going to stick down this little whisk wherever it looks good. There we go, with some art glitter glue. There, get my fingers out of it. And then I will pop up this little girl gnome with some Stampin' Up! Dimensionals. So I cover the back, I peeled off all the release paper, and then I'm sticking her down. So I just think she's super cute. There we go. And then I'm going to stick these two little oven mitts that's from that same Gnome Dies Baking Add-ons in pure poppy cardstock. Remember, if you miss what I used, you can check out my blog. Everything's listed there. There we go. Isn't she cute? Oh, I just think she's turned out adorable. And then I'm going to use, I cut out a few more of these little icing hearts from the Gnome Dies Baking Add-ons. And I'm going to pop up three in a visual triangle, one on her hat, and then two in the lower left-hand corner of the card. You know, bring in a little bit more red. There we go. And isn't that sweet? I just think it's so cute. But I'm a little concerned about the pattern paper on the outside. That's bothering me. The little pattern right there behind the, behind the booth. It's a little bit busy. So I'm just using my Cricut little spatula tool, and I lifted up the stuff, and I'm going to slide in this little piece that I cut out with the Build-A-Booth die again. I just cut out the little relief piece with paper from that same barbecue pad, but it's a little bit more toned down. So if it's something's a little bit too busy, you can change it. So I'm going to slip this piece in, sticking it down with some ATG tape, like I said. And there you go. It's fixed. And then I'll just add some glue to the back of this little bowl. No one will know the difference except for you and me. I just think it looks not as busy, right? It was a little bit competing with everything. You still have that neat, colorful platter on the edge, but it's not competing with your images so much. Then I'm going to add a little bit of glue to those foam dots that I peeled up behind the hat. There we go. I'm going to make sure that's stuck down well. Fun stuff. So now I'm pulling out the odds and ends from the barbecue doodlebug line, and I'm going to add this cute little barbecue to the inside with some art glitter glue. There we go. And I will put it on the lower right-hand corner, and I will trim off the overhang with a pair of scissors. And I also cut one more of those icing hearts from that Gnome Dies Baking Add-ons, cut from pure poppy cardstock, and I'm going to add that right there with some art glitter glue. And I will trim off, like I said, that overhang with a pair of scissors. And now I'm going to add a few little highlights with my Secura white jelly roll pen and a number 10, of course. I'll add a little highlights to the little face because, of course, your barbecue would have a little face, right? There we go. And I'm going to stamp a sentiment from the stamp set Fired Up. There's a perfect sentiment for this. There it is. And I'm going to stamp that on the inside with VersaFine Clara Nocturne ink. It says, get fired up, it's your birthday. It's perfect for a barbecue card. But of course, I'm going to fart around getting this organized, getting it in the right spot using my Misty and you know, this is like a little acetate sheet from Simon Says Stamp to line things up. But anyways, I'll just talk as we're working this through. Remember that, you know, you can still get your hands on the Gotta Have It Now. If you'd like to wait until later on in the release, you'll be able to buy things a la carte on release day, on the day of the hop. So make sure you come back tomorrow and check out, there'll be more videos, more projects. There'll be a hop on Thursday. Lots of fun stuff coming up. There we go. So stamping that twice to make it nice, right? The Laura Basson comment. I don't know if you watch her videos. You should. They're awesome. And there we go. Isn't that cute? I just think it turned out so sweet. So thank you so much for stopping by. Be sure to hop on over to the Jaded Blossom blog, Be Inspired, the Jaded Blossom store to get your hands on the Gotta Have It Now. Otherwise, you got to wait till Friday and come back to watch more videos tomorrow and get inspired. Thanks, everybody. And that's all. Bye.